Hi, my name is Aida Begić. I'm a filmmaker from Sarajevo, Bosnia and Herzegovina. I'm a movie director, but I also write scripts for my films, and I also am part of the production team of my films as well. As a 16-year-old teenager, I witnessed the siege of Sarajevo that lasted for 3.5 years. And during this time, I decided to become a student of directing. In this period, I learned many things. It was a very unpleasant experience in general. But I learned about the importance of art and the importance of cinema, because in those years, we really didn't have food or clothes, electricity. We could get killed every second, but at the same time, we had the need to produce, to create art and to consume art. Basically, that is when I understood that art is like an essential human need.
Meni je Sarajevo nekako onaj, kako bi se izrazio, kao neka djevojka koju sam volio, s kojom sam hodio i raskinuo. Ali ne mogu nikako da iz glave odbacim, kao prva ljubav.
Sve dođe i prođe, al ti si zauvijek, Sarajevo moje, moj jedini je svijet. Sve dođe i prođe, al ti si zauvijek, dušmanima otrov.
I think that also this experience marked me as an artist, as a filmmaker. So I'm in my work very occupied with the questions of identity. I also treat subjects of post-war traumas of women and children. And I'm also trying to find poetry in these post-apocalyptic, post-war times in my country and elsewhere. Cinema before the 90s, before the war, it was dominated by male directors, and I would say that all the subjects were treated from a male perspective mainly. We only had in Bosnia one woman director who made a feature film before the war. And after the war, there was this generation, starting from my generation, of women filmmakers, directors, scriptwriters, producers, that actually entered and changed atmosphere in filmmaking on the set, but also the content changed, the way how we started to treat women female characters, and also how we started to treat reality around us. And I'm very proud to belong that I'm very proud to say that I belong to these pioneers of female filmmakers in Bosnia.
Što čekam, jer sad vremena vifte, jel da vore? Sve ću vas pobiti ovdje. Šta je?
Rizo!
Brš!
before the pandemic started, I was in preps of my fourth feature film called A Ballad. We were supposed to start filming very soon, but then everything stopped. And at the beginning, I couldn't believe that it's the second time in my life that I'm witnessing such a great historical changes. And I must say that I was quite depressed. But then I tried to find a way how to work. So I continued working on my script. Because I know that the most constructive way for me to deal with the reality that is not so nice around me is through cinema. Sometimes I think that I even make films in order to survive not so bright reality around me. I knew that somehow I felt that nothing will be the same after all this stops. After isolation was over in Bosnia, we continued working on preparations for my film. I must say that I feel very alive and very nice working with actors, going to the locations, and this feeling is somehow familiar from these war times that I witnessed a long time ago. I know that this need of people to survive, this reflex, this strength of survival is so strong that it can overcome every bad thing that comes in front of your way. I wanted to participate in EVROVIZION Crossing Stories and Spaces symposium because as a filmmaker I really believe that people can make bridges between each other, and the way how we can make it is by getting to know each other better. I guess that cinema as I see it is a possible bridge between people, possible bridge between cultures. The fact that language of cinema is so universal is really helping us to understand that we are much more similar as a human beings than we think sometimes. I also treat in my films this question of migration and displacements, and I think that we nowadays we live in one paradox because politics is telling us that we are so different and there are some walls and things that cannot be broken and between us, so that we cannot understand each other. But the fact is completely different, reality is completely different because cities have never been more similar than today. The way how we dress was never more similar from Japan until through Europe to America. So I think that people are much more similar, even cultures are much more connected than ever before in history of civilization probably. So there is this paradox of insisting of, in these post-truth times, of course, of insisting of the differences that we cannot bridge. And I guess that actions like this, the communication between people, symposiums, and especially films, can help us to understand that we are much, much more similar than we think.
Biliyorum.
Abi biliyorum Andil. Abi biliyorum.
Ben biliyor musun? Biliyorum.
Abi biliyorum Andil.
Allah korusun.
Biliyorum Andil. Biliyorum Andil.
Biliyorum
Andil. Ay abi. Biliyorum Andil. Biliyorum Andil.
Al bakalım canım.
Ben biliyor musun? Biliyorum. Biliyorum.
Sen aşırılırız.
Biliyorum Andil. Allah korusun.
So I truly hope to see you next year in Sarajevo.